So now let us look at some sample questions, some more sample questions. So in this question, you are asked to prove that 11 power n plus 2 plus 12 power 2 n plus 1 is divisible by 133. So how do we do this? So first, so let us do it in a short way. I won't explain it very much. So first, verification step. So let this be P of n. So for P of 1, which is nothing but 11 power 3 plus 12 power 3 is divisible by 133. So you have to prove that 11 power 3 plus 12 power 3 is divisible by 133. So you have to do calculations. So what I can do is so 11 power 3, 121 into 11, 121, 121. So 1331 plus 144 times 12, 288, 144, 82, so 1725. So if I add these two, I get 6503. So 3056. So you just need to check whether 3056 is divisible by 133. So let us divide and see whether the remainder is 0. So 3056, 133. So 133 into 3, sorry, 132 into 2s are 266. So 15, so 1, and so you have 39, 396, 396. And 133 into 3s are 8. So this is 8. So 3059. So 3059, 399. 3s are 399. So 3059 is nothing but 133 into 23. So 3059 is divisible by 133, hence P of 1 is true. So now let us assume that P of n is true, that is 11 power n plus 2 plus 12 power 2n plus 1 is equal to 133 times some number k. So let us assume this. So now what is to be proven? So to be proven is nothing but 11 power n plus 3 plus 12 power 2n plus 3 is equal to 133 times some number k dash. So for n is equal to n plus 1, n plus 3 plus 2n plus 3 is also a multiple of 133. So let us start with this. So 11 power n plus 3 plus 12 power 2n plus 3. So this is equal to, so first 11 power n plus 3 is 11 times 11 power n plus 2 plus 12 power 2n plus 3. So that is equal to, so now 11 power n plus 2 has been assumed as 133k minus 12 power 2n plus 1. So 11 times 133k minus 12 power 2n plus 1 plus 12 power 2n plus 3. That is equal to 11 into 133k, this is a multiple of 133, there is no doubt about it, minus 11 into 12 power 2n plus 1 plus 12 power 2n plus 3. So that is equal to, so this is a multiple of 133, there is no doubt about it, minus of, so in these two, I will take 12 power 2n plus 1 as common. So 12 power 2n plus 1, if I take it as, or plus 12 power 2n plus 1, if I take it as common, you have 12 square remaining, that is 144 minus 11. So from these two, if I take 12 power 2n plus 1 as common, you have 2 12s remaining here and you have 11 remaining here, 144 minus 11. That is nothing but 133 times some k plus 12 power 2n plus 1 times 144 minus 11 is again 133. So this is also a multiple of 133, this is also a multiple of 133, that is equal to 133 times some k dash. So we have proved that this is a multiple of 133, hence P of n plus 1 is true, hence by PMI, P of n is true for all n. So in the next question, you are asked to prove that x power 2n minus y power 2n is divisible by x plus y for all n belongs to natural numbers. So first, let us check for p of 1. So p of 1 is nothing but x square minus y square is divisible by x plus y, which is obviously true because x square minus y square is x plus y into x minus y. That is, x plus y into x minus y is divisible by x plus y, so which is obviously true. So, as a first step. Second, so let us assume that x power 2n or x power 2m minus y power 2m is divisible by x plus y. So, let us assume that x minus 2m minus x power 2m minus y power 2m is divisible by x minus y, x plus y. So, that means I will assume that this is equal to x plus y times some function of x comma y. So, x plus y times some function of x comma y, that I'll assume. So, what is to be proved? I have to prove that x power 2m plus 2 minus y power 2m plus 2, because if you put m plus 1 in the place of m, you get 2m plus 2 is also x plus y times some function, some other function of x comma y. So, this is what you need to prove. So, now let us start. So, let us take x power 2m plus 2 minus y power 2m plus 2, that is equal to. So, x power 2m plus 2 can be written as x square times x power 2m, and x power 2m can be written as x plus y times f of x comma y plus y power 2m. So, this is x power 2m plus 2, x square times x power 2m. In the place of x power 2m, I can write x plus y into f of x y plus y power 2m minus y power 2m plus 2. So, that is equal to. So, if you multiply the brackets, x square times x plus y times f of x y plus x square y power 2m minus y power 2m plus 2 is y square y power 2m. So, this first expression obviously contains x plus y. So, x plus y times some function of x comma y, x square into this can be written as f dash plus. So, if you take y power 2m as common, so you get x square minus y square. So, we know that x square minus y square is also x plus y into x minus y. So, you have an x plus y here, you have an x plus y here. So, you can take x plus y as common and you get some function of x comma y, some other function of x comma y. So, it does not matter what this function is. So, you get x plus y times some function of x comma y. Hence, this is also divisible by x plus y. Hence, p of m plus 1 is true. Hence, by principle of mathematical induction, p of n is true for all natural numbers. So, now in this question, you are asked to prove that root of a plus root of a plus root of a plus so on up to root of a, if you have n radical signs, any number of radical signs is less than 1 plus root of 4a plus 1 by 2. So, you are asked to prove this inequality for all natural numbers. So, you are using principle of mathematical induction. So, first step, verification step. So, I will verify the statement for n is equal to 1. That is, you have only one radical sign, that is root a is less than 1 plus root of 4a plus 1 by 2. So, you need to verify this. So, let us see if this works. So, I will cross multiply this. This implies, so this relation by implies 2 root a is less than 1 plus root of 4a plus 1. So, this by implies root 2a, sorry, 2 root a minus 1 is less than root of 4a plus 1. So, that by implies, I will square it, 4a plus 1 minus 4 root a is less than 4a plus 1. So, 4a plus 1 and 4a plus 1 gets cancelled. This by implies minus 4 root a is less than 0, which is always true because root a is positive, 4 is positive and you have a negative sign here. So, this is always less than 0. Now, P of 1 is true. Next, I'll assume that P of M is true. P of M is true. That is, root of A plus root of A plus so on, N radicals, M radicals is less than 1 plus root of 4A plus 1 by 2. So, now I need to prove the same thing for M radicals. I have to prove the same thing for M plus 1 radicals. So, that is the third step. So, what happens if you have M plus 1 radicals? So let us start with this. So, root of A plus root of A plus so on, root of A up to M radicals is less than 1 plus root of 4A plus 1 by 2. So, now I will add an A on both sides and take a root again. So, this contains now M plus 1 radicals. So, this is less than this. So, this if you take LCM, so this becomes, this is less than root of 2A plus 1 plus root of 4A plus 1 by 2. 4A plus 1 by 2. So, that is less than root of, so I will multiply numerator and denominator with a 2. It is 4A plus 2 plus 2 root 4A plus 1 by 4. So, this is less than root of, so 4A plus 2 can be written as 4A plus 1 plus 1 plus 2 root 4A plus 1 by 4. Now, 4A plus 1 can be written as root of 4A plus 1 whole square. So, now this is of the form A square plus 1 can be written as 1 square, A square plus B square plus 2 into 1 into this. So, this is nothing but this is less than root of root 4A plus 1 plus 1 whole square by 4. So, that is less than, if you take the square root, 1 plus root of 4A plus 1 by 2. So, that is, if you have M plus 1 radical signs, that expression is also less than 1 plus root of 4A plus 1 by 2. Hence, P of M plus 1 is true. Hence, by PMI, P of N is true for all natural numbers.